Rethinking Dark Matter Within the EDW Perspective. The most difficult problem of cosmology in our days is the dark matter and dark energy. What is dark matter? Contemporary thinkers believe that the gravity of dark matter must therefore be the glue that holds galaxies like our own together. The fate of the universe itself seems to hinge on the total amount of dark matter and the properties of a mysterious form of energy, often called dark energy, that appears to be counteracting the effects of gravity on large scales, p. 445. Dark matter is the name given to mass that emits no detectable radiation. We infer its existence from its gravitational effects. Dark matter is the name we give to whatever unseen influence provides the gravity needed to explain the motions we observe. Dark energy is the name given to the unseen influence that may be causing the expansion of the universe to accelerate with time, pages 446 to 447. There are direct and indirect methods of detecting the dark matter. 6. For instance, the amount of dark matter in a galaxy is determined by comparing the mass of the galaxy with its luminosity, mass to light ratio 7. The main problem is that plotting the orbital speeds observed at different distances for most spiral galaxies shows that these speeds do not drop off with distance from the center. It is believed that in the first billion years of the universe, dark matter had no role even if it was present in that period. In fact, we consider that the EU of dark matter, the mega EU, appeared when, in the macro EU, the galaxies and the cluster of galaxies were formed. It means that if any galaxy was not formed in a particular place, then there was no EDW with the mega entities that correspond to the galaxies. Probably, there are mega entities that correspond to the individual galaxies, but there are also mega entities that correspond to the clusters of galaxies. Let us introduce the chronological order of some people who have worked on the dark matter. Krauss 8 mentioned the names of some important people working in cosmology in the first decades of the 20th century 9, but we added other persons on his list: Lord Kelvin, who introduced the dark bodies, and Poincaré, 1906, who used the term dark matter; Lemaître, who proposed the Big Bang in the 1920s, Hubble, one of the most important astronomers, colon 10 together with Milton Humason, he proposed the Hubble law and radio astronomy pioneer. Krauss mentioned a problem: comparing with the abundance of light elements, the density of protons and neutrons produced by Big Bang should be doubled that it exists, and consequently, it was necessary the introduction of dark matter, something mysterious that flowed between the stars and ran the whole gravitational show we call a galaxy, p. 46. 11. It has been supposed that the particles that produce the dark matter are weakly interacting massive particles, WIMPs, action, neutrino, neutralino, or many other particles. 12. It is completely meaningless to search for the microparticles that compose the dark matter, since the mega entities belong to the mega EU. Therefore, the microparticles do not exist for the dark matter, and the dark matter does not exist for any kind of microparticles. Obviously, from our EDW perspective, there are no atoms, microparticles, that form the dark matter. The movements of the galaxies, their masses, have to be regarded in relationship with other galaxies and not with the masses of planets, the macro EU, to form the galaxies. Within the macro EU, the galaxies do not have any ontological status, but only the planets that represent, for us, the galaxies. The same principle is available for investigating the relationship between the microparticles and the macro entities. There are ED laws for ED entities. 13. The microparticles correspond to the planets, so it would be wrong to consider that the microparticles form the planets. In consequence, it would be wrong to consider that the planets form the galaxies. Indeed, the missing mass is not something else in the macro EU, but there are the mega entities, the mega EU, that correspond to the galaxies, the macro EU. 14. In the mega EU, the planets or the microparticles do not even exist. This EU has more ED entities and ED laws than the macro EU or the micro EU. From our viewpoint, dark matter does not exist within our universe at all. In fact, there are no mysterious particles that we cannot observe empirically, since they do not exist in any macro EW 15 that we have discovered. There are only some phenomena that involve the ED entities and the ED interactions that belong to an EDW. These phenomena only correspond to some strange phenomena that cannot be explained in the macro EU. The macro EU that contains macro objects, planets, and stars that form, for us, the galaxies, is not the largest macro EU. In fact, largest has no meaning regarding the comparisons of EDWs. It is a notion that presupposes the notion of space, but in our course 2016, we indicated that space and time, or space-time, cannot have any ontology. Moreover, an EU does not exist for any EDW, so the notion the largest EU has no meaning. A galaxy, no ontological status, in the macro EU corresponds to an EDW, the mega EU.16 essentially, a star appeared with other planets that formed in a flattened disk surrounding it, p. This idea is quite important in explaining the dark matter of a galaxy. Let us imagine a disk, a CD, through an air by a human hand in an empty space, long distance from any planet and their gravitation. The CD will rotate exactly as a galaxy rotates. The margin of that disk rotates with a speed much greater than the speed of points closer to the center of the disk. The force acting on the disk, centrifugal force, corresponds to the micro forces that bring together these microparticles and their rotation, even if we cannot understand the origin of this centrifugal force. In the micro EU, there are the microparticles, their micro forces, and their dark rotation. In the macro EU, there is a disk with a centrifugal force, and maybe gravitational force. According to the principles of EDW perspective, the microparticles exist just because of their interactions within the micro EU, and the macro entities, stones, planets, exist because of their interactions within the macro EU. The dark matter, the mega entities, from the mega EU corresponds to the planets and the empty space among them, which only represent, for us, the galaxies. Essentially, from the EDW perspective, the mega entities that represent the mega EU exist just because of the mega interactions between them within this EU. A mega entity does not exist for a planet, or a galaxy, a planet does not exist for a mega entity, just because their interaction is meaningless, since the mega entity and the planet are ed entities that belong to EDWs which do not exist for the other !17. In 1937, Zwicky proposed that using Einstein's method of gravitational lens, it is possible to test general relativity, to magnify more distant objects, and to find out why clusters appear to weigh more than what can be accounted for by visible matter, p. 51. More important is the observation about the dark matter halos. 18, big blobs of dark matter in which galaxies were embedded, were necessary to keep the structures of many spiral galaxies stable. 19, p. 334. The halos, no ontological status within the macro EU, and the galaxies, no ontological status, formed by planets, macro ontological status, correspond to the mega entities that exist in the mega EU. How was each galaxy formed? The main force was gravitation that acts and isolates clumps of matter on all scales, p. 334. This idea mirrors one of Gabriel Vaccarelli's main principles from his works, 2008, etc. In this case, the main principle is the interactions constitute the entities determine their interactions. According to the gravitation, we cannot explain the movements of planets that are at the margin of the disk. These planets have too much speed in relationship to gravitation. Our bodies, our eyes, are particular entities within the macro EU where we can find the planets and their movements. We cannot see any supersystem galaxies since this supersystem is an entity, or maybe an amalgam of entities, that exists in the mega EU. That mega EU does not exist for our bodies, for planets and galaxies that we can observe, or for our minds since all these entities belong to EDWs. One of the most important actual cosmologists regarding dark matter is James Peebles, who mentions that it might be the DM that gravitationally binds clusters of galaxies. 15, 16, p. 120, but we have to be aware that the dark matter does not bind clusters of galaxies, and the mega entities that belong to the mega EU correspond to the clusters of galaxies, planets and empty spaces among them. In 2015, Peebles writes about the galaxy phenomenology, proposing the concept of pure disk galaxies in which most of the stars move in streams in directions close to the plane of the disk, as in whirlpools and bars, p. 12248. However, from the EDW perspective, the disk galaxies have no ontology. Peebles's galaxy phenomenology sends directly to our hyper-ontology of EDWs. It is about the mega entity, a mega disk, within the mega EU.